here with another short reviewer short, this time the 2009 movie Fanboys. Directed by Kyle Newman, screenplay by Ernest Cline and Adam F. Goldberg, story by Dan Pollock and Ernest Cline. Now anybody who's been watching my videos should know that Ernie Cline's book Ready Player One is one of my favourite reads, so naturally I had quite high expectations for this film. This is a road trip comedy set in 1998. Eric Butler reunites with his old friends at a Halloween party after not seeing them for 3 years. He discovers that they haven't matured at all since high school. They still have the same jobs and are still utterly obsessed with Star Wars. All of them are naturally really excited about the release of Star Wars Episode 1 of Phantom Menace in 6 months. There is tension between Eric and his old friend Linus, as he's bitter that he sold out and went to work for his father's car dealership, instead of being the next big thing in comics, as they said in school. But when his other friend Hutch and Windows inform him that Linus has cancer and only 3 to 4 months to live, 2 months short of the release of Star Wars, Butler decides to revive the friend's old dream they've had since school, to drive to California, to break into Skywalker Mansion and steal a rough cut of the film before it comes out, or more importantly, before Linus dies. The film follows their friends on their epic quest from Ohio to California. They encounter a number of problems along the way. A burst tire, arrest by the police, an angry pimp, and a fight with some Trekkies.
Okay, a Trekkie is derogatory at this point in the game. Trekker is what we're called now. Trekker.
This film is, I imagine, quite the nostalgia fest for the Star Wars fan. Though, being 1 year old in 1998, I can't say I empathise with the characters. I'm clearly not who this film is aimed at. However, I am a Star Wars fan, and this film is packed full of references to the original trilogy and some of the prequels. In fact, I only saw some of the references on my second viewing, and I'm still confident that I missed some of them. Not only are there references galore, but there's some great cameos from Star Wars stars, like Billy Dee Williams and Carrie Fisher. There's also a somewhat unexpected cameo from Star Trek legend William Shatner. However, I must say the actor that pleased me most in this film was Seth Rogen. He played numerous characters in this film and had many one-liners that made me laugh out loud.
Okay, Captain Picard is not gay, he's British.
This film is purposely absurd, which I like. It's a comedy, it's not meant to be serious. When the film tries to be serious, it feels a little forced, but it's not that bad. What I really don't like about this film is the inclusion of the character Zoe. I have no problem with female characters, but I feel like this character was just thrown in for the sake of having a girl in the film. And then they throw in a romantic subplot that is rushed and unexplored that really lets the film down. Overall, I give this film 2.9 to 3 out of 5 clocks. It's good, but not amazing. It's funny, but sometimes it feels like it's trying a bit too hard. And the thrown in female character actually takes a lot away from this film. So, tell me what you think about the film Fanboys. Do you agree? Do you disagree? Tell me in the comments, or even make a video about it and tweet it at me or post it on my Facebook wall. Since we're talking about Ernest Cline this week, my recommendation is Ernest Cline's poetry book, The Importance of Being Ernest, in this lovely new edition. It is gorgeous. This book itself, and the illustrations in it, which are great, and the poetry in it is utterly hilarious. Much better than the film Fanboys, much more like the writing I fell in love with in Ready Player One. That'll be all this week, but I will inform you that I've joined an awesome collab channel called Vlogfighteria, link in the doobly-doo. I'll be vlogging there every Tuesday, and there'll be awesome vloggers vlogging every other day of the week too. So go check that channel out, and goodbye!